Hello, everyone. My name is Sister Eleanor. I'm a member of the Teo community of Interfaith Franciscans. And in the background, you hear the bells of Teze, which are calling us to our evening prayer. I hope that all of you have had a good day today and that you will have a good sleep and rest tonight. Remember, of course, that Doves for Peace is on at 8 p.m. GMT. So you might want to listen in on that on the Doves for Peace channel. There's always something wonderful going on there, and it'll actually help you to have a better rest when you listen. So at any rate, we're going to start our prayers today. And today is the feast day, and I always tell you the feast days of various people in the Roman Catholic Church, because I think a lot of them have led very interesting lives, majority of them have, not necessarily what we are called to do in all aspects, but they did what, as I said, what they were supposed to do, the mission they were supposed to do for their Father, Mother, God. And today is the feast of Saint Ignatius of Loyola. And I mention him specifically because he was the founder of the Jesuit order, the Society of Jesus. Thank you, same to you, Brother Sean. And the Society of Jesus is the order of priests that Pope Francis belongs to. So at any rate, I think he's important for us because he's related, obviously, to the spirituality of Pope Francis, who is the Pope of our time at present. Saint Ignatius of Loyola was born in 1491 of a noble family in the castle of Loyola. He was born to a noble Basque family, and I believe that's an area that's in the south of France and north of Spain, like right in there between France and Spain. And the Basque people have their own way of talking, I believe, their own dialect of French, I guess tempered with Spanish, and they're certainly their own culture. And I knew one Basque person in my lifetime who went to school with me in high school. She was Basque heritage, but she was American. So he became a knight, and then later on through sickness, and he laid down his sword and converted to a life of doing good works and, you know, really following Jesus in a more, a different fashion. He gave away all of his goods, all of his fine clothing and all of that, and he founded the Society of Jesus, popularly known as the Jesuits. He wrote a book called The Spiritual Exercises, which is very interesting, and I have to sometimes revisit that again. The last time I read it, I didn't really understand it, and that's been some time ago. And they concentrate the Society of Jesus on being very obedient to the Pope, a strong spiritual formation, foreign missions, and education of the youth, regardless of their class, which was a big thing years ago, especially. When you were poor class, you really didn't get much of an education. And so they created universities and schools all across the globe. And we have a couple really fine universities and schools here in Philadelphia that are founded by the Jesuits. St. Joseph University and St. Joseph Prep, for one, in the United States here in Philadelphia. And just as a reminder, we are getting ready here in Philadelphia for a visit from the Pope. He's going to be coming September 23rd to the 25th. And believe me, the city of Philadelphia has been preparing all through the summer and before that for his visit coming very soon now. All of the hotels and everywhere is just entirely booked in three states, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and Delaware, are entirely booked for the visit that's coming. He'll be having an open-air mass in an area square where there's going to be hundreds of people. You have to have certain passes to see him. I did see Pope John Paul II years ago when he was here, and I had a pass that I got from a group of nuns that gave it to me and my mother, and we both went out there when I was young and saw Pope John Paul II in the same area. So enough about all that, but it's going to be gridlock here for like 3 days and a lot of security and all that kind of stuff. So anyway, just to let you know what's going on here, and we're very happy that he's coming for the conference, World Conference of Families. So let us begin now with our evening prayer. O God, come to my assistance. O Lord, make haste to help me. Glory to our Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus, who is our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And I did forget, and I remember now, our little candle lit for peace. It's going down further and further. I almost don't have one now. And today, I am praying a prayer from Pope John Paul II for peace. He says, truth will build peace if every individual sincerely acknowledges not only his rights, but also his duties towards others. And for this we pray. Justice will build peace if in practice everyone respects the rights of others and actually fulfills his duties towards them, and for this we pray. Love will build peace if people feel the need of others as their own and share what they have with others, and for this we pray. Freedom will build peace and make it thrive if, in the choice of the means to that end, people act according to reason and assume responsibility for their own actions. And for this we pray. And we all have to assume responsibility for our own actions. You know, we all have a I know with myself, I have a tendency, I could blame other people for what happens, but really ultimately it's my own actions that dictate what happens in my life. And now we have a poem today. And it's really not so much a poem, but it's Psalm 23 at the beginning of our prayers. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me by the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table for me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, and my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of my Lord forever and ever. Just really concentrate on that last statement, because that is key. That surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life. Let us hold on to that, that goodness and mercy shall follow us for the rest of our days. And I will dwell in the house of my Lord forever and ever. And I will have a relationship with my Holy Father, Mother God, forever and ever. We will dwell together in the temple, which is our own body and soul. Let's continue now for Psalm 41, which is the prayer of a sick person. And the antiphon is, Lord, lay your healing hand upon me, for I have sinned. So let us take this psalm, anyone who is sick right now, anybody who is praying for someone sick, just take this psalm and just take it into your heart and bless your soul with this psalm and bless the souls of others around you. Happy the man who considers the poor and the weak. The Lord will save him on the day of evil. He will guard him and give him life and make him happy in the land, and will not give him up to the will of his foes. The Lord will help him on his bed of pain. He will bring him back from sickness to health. As for me, I said, Lord, have mercy on me. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. My foes are speaking evil against me. How long before he dies and his name be forgotten? They come to visit me and they speak empty words. Their hearts are full of malice. They spread it abroad. My enemies whisper together against me. They all weigh up the evil which is on me. Some deadly thing has fastened upon him. He will not rise again from where he lies. Thus even my friend, in whom I trusted, who ate my bread, has turned against me. But you, O Lord, have mercy on me. Let me rise once more and I will repay them. By this I shall know that you are my friend, if my foes do not shout in triumph over me. If you uphold me, I shall be unharmed, and set in your presence forevermore. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, from age to age. Amen and amen. Glory to our Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus, who is our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Lord Jesus, you are the healer of soul and body. Blessed are the merciful, for they will obtain mercy. Teach us to come to the aid of all of our brothers and sisters who are needy, in a spirit of brotherly and sisterly love, that in turn we may be received and strengthened by you. And we say again, Lord, lay your healing hand upon me, for I have sinned. Now let us continue in a spirit of love and a spirit of healing today, and pray Psalm 46, which speaks of God as our refuge and strength. Our antiphon is, the mighty Lord is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. God is for us, a refuge and strength, a helper close at hand in time of distress. So we shall not fear, though the earth should rock, though the mountains fall into the depths of the sea, even though its waters rage and foam, even though the mountains be shaken by its waves. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. So do not fear. The waters of a river give joy to God's city, the holy place where the Most High dwells. God is within. It cannot be shaken. God will help it at the dawning of the day. Nations are in tumult. Kingdoms are shaken. He lifts his voice, and the earth shrinks away. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Come, consider the works of the Lord, the redoubtable deeds he has done on the earth. He puts an end to wars all over the earth. The bow, he breaks. The spear, he snaps. He burns the shields with fire. Be still and know that I am God. Supreme among the nations, supreme on the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Glory to our Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus, who is our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. All-powerful Father, Mother God, the refuge and strength of your people, you protect in adversity and defend in prosperity those who put their trust in you. May they persevere in seeking your will and find their way to you through obedience. And the antiphon again is, the mighty Lord is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. And indeed, the mighty Lord is with us right now, even as we speak, even as we pray. Right now, the Lord is with us. And the God of Jacob, the God of all eternity, of the universe, who was from the beginning, before the beginning of time, is with us now. Now let us pray a canticle from Revelation. And the antiphon is, all nations will come and worship before you, O Lord. It's a hymn of adoration. And it is so very fitting that for all that the Lord has given us and all that we are, everything that we are has been created by our Father, Mother God, who sustains us with every breath, every day, that we should give back a slight hymn of adoration to our Father, Mother God. So let us begin. Mighty and wonderful, all wonderful are your works, Lord God Almighty. Righteous and true are your ways, O King of the nations. Who would dare refuse you honor? or the glory that is due your name, O Lord. Since you alone are holy, all nations shall come and worship in your presence. Your mighty deeds are clearly seen. Glory to our Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus, who is our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The antiphon again, all nations will come and worship before you, O Lord. Now I would ask you to consider a reading from 1 Peter chapter 5, which I shall read now. To the elders among you, I, a fellow elder, a witness of Christ's sufferings, and a sharer in the glory that is to be revealed, make this appeal. God's flock is in your midst. Give it a shepherd's care. Watch over it willingly as God would have you do, not under constraint, and not for shameful profit either, but generously from the heart. Be examples to the flock, not lording it over those assigned to you, so that when the chief shepherd appears, you will win for yourselves the unfading crown of glory. And I just want to make mention about this as we listen to that word in our very souls, that it, of course, Peter is talking to those elders that were over various groups of the beginning Christians. But also he is speaking to each and every one of us, because we all have people in our lives that we interact with, that we might have to care for in some way. So he's just telling us to watch over each other and give generously of our time and our talents, not for any hope of gain, but just out of pure love. So let us just have a moment of silence to just ponder these words in our heart. Our response to this is, this is a man who loved his brethren and ever prayed for them. This is a man who loved his brethren and ever prayed for them. He spent himself in their service and ever prayed for them. Glory to our Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus, who is our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And that response was geared mainly to today's Vespers, which we're offering for St. Ignatius, in honor of St. Ignatius Loyola, who watches over us today during these Vesper period times. And also in contrast to all of the masculinity now that we are praying due to this prayer being in honor of St. Ignatius of Loyola, we now have the counterbalance through the Magnificat of the femininity of God through the Canticle of Mary. So let us pray the Canticle of Mary together. And the antiphon is, of what use is it to a man to gain the whole world if he pays for it by losing his soul? So let us now pray with Mary this canticle. Our souls proclaim the greatness of the Lord, and our spirits rejoice in God, who is our Savior. For he has looked with favor on all of us who are his lowly servants. From this day, all generations will call each and every one of us here blessed. The Almighty has done great things for us, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm, and he scatters all of us who are proud and do not need God in our conceit. He has cast down all of those who are mighty from their thrones, and he has lifted up all of his dear lowly ones. He fills all of us who are hungry with good things, and the rich he sends away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he remembers his promises of mercy, the promises he made to our fathers, to our mothers, to Abraham, our patriarch, and Sarah, our matriarch, and all of their children up to the present generation, forever. Glory to our Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus, who is our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The antiphon again. Of what use is it to a man to gain the whole world if he pays for it by losing his soul? Now, dear ones, in the spirit of that generous love, let us join together and pray for one another in our intercessions. Jesus Christ is worthy of all praise, for he was appointed high priest among men and their representative before God, our representative before God. That was his role that he was put on earth to do, like we each have our own mission. We honor him, and in our weakness we pray, bring salvation to your people, Lord. You can write what you'd like on the chat board for all of us to pray, or you could wait until the end and just in the silence of your own hearts, offer to God whatever you would like. You marvelously illuminate your world through distinguished leaders of holy men and women. Let all of us rejoice in such splendor. Bring salvation to your people, Lord. You forgive all of the failings of your people, and you forgave them in the past when their holy leaders like Moses sought your compassion. Through the intercession of all holy men and women, continue to purify and sanctify all of us who are your holy people. And we ask that you bring salvation to your people, Lord. In the midst of their brothers and sisters, you have for all eternity anointed holy ones and filled them with your Holy Spirit to overflowing. Fill all the leaders of your people with that same spirit. And for this we pray, bring salvation to your people, Lord. You yourself are the only visible possession of all of our holy leaders. Let none of them, won at the price of your blood, remain ever far from you. For this we pray, bring salvation to your people, Lord. The shepherds of all congregations and faith traditions everywhere, keep your flock from being snatched out of your hand. Through them, you gave your flock eternal life. Save all of us who have died, those for whom you gave up your life. Bring salvation to your people, Lord. With Brother Sean, we hold all here and thank God for your gifts to us. This we pray, bring salvation to your people, Lord. We pray also that everyone here may be filled with your Holy Spirit, that all may be touched, all of those who are logged in and all of those who are not logged in. Just we ask, Lord, that you touch them in a very special way. And not only them, but their families and their friends and all of those people that are in their hearts who have asked them for prayer. Bring salvation to your people, Lord. We pray with Jean Christie, Jeannie, for myself and Elizabeth, and we thank you for that, Jean, and for John, and all that are on our lists. We ask you to bless all these intentions, and we ask for salvation for your people, Lord. With Brother Sean, we hold all of God's children of all faiths and none who are despondent, unwell, and in need of support. Lord, send them your Holy Spirit now. We ask that you bring salvation to your people, Lord. With Brother Sean, we hold John, Jean's husband, that he will overcome his fears and seek professional help for his long-standing back problem. And we ask that you bring salvation to your people, Lord. With Brother Sean, we ask for a blessing on all our beloved pets, and with Jean, for all animals. And we say, bring salvation to all of your people, Lord. With Jean, we also pray for world peace. And we say, bring salvation to your people, Lord. And Lord, we also pray for all of those people throughout the world who do not have the basic necessities of life, food, shelter, water, and love, especially the children, especially the elderly and the sick. And we ask, and the animals, all the animals, and we ask that you just take them and bless them with all of the above. And beyond that, bring salvation to your people, Lord. We ask you and we pray for our Earth Mother Gaia, that she may reflect the vision that you have for her, and we may become good stewards of all the resources that she gives us. We ask that if we cannot do anything physically, that we at least pray for Earth Mother Gaia to be blessed, and that we stop all of the intentions that are not truly from God towards her. We pray, bring salvation to your people, Lord. And with Brother Sean, we pray for myself and Elizabeth as we both continue to grow strong during these building trials. And we thank God for the building. Yes, there is some trials that come with it, but it does make us stronger. Each and every one of us gets stronger through the trials, if we can just but hold on to our Father, Mother, God. As I always say, I always think of that woman who just went to touch the hem of Jesus' garment to be healed. So if we can even just hold on to the end of his garment, just really hold on tight, he will pull us through. Bring salvation to your people, Lord. Now you can continue to write if you like, but I'll have a period of silence where you can just offer to God whatever is upon your heart today. Do it in a spirit of joy and thanksgiving, if you will. Praise you, God, and thank you, and bring salvation to your people, Lord. And now together, let us form a link with each other, a circle of love. And though we be far apart, we are closer than we can imagine in the Spirit of God, in the Holy Spirit of God. And let us pray our Father, Mother, God now. Our Father, Mother, God, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, and your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, and yours is the power, and yours is the glory, now and forever. Amen. Our concluding prayer. O God, who raised up Saint Ignatius of Loyola to further the greater glory of your name, grant that by his help we may imitate him in fighting this good fight on earth, and merit to receive with him a crown in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We have our blessing now that follows. May the Lord bless us, protect us from every evil, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. God give you the best of memories. Christ give you pardon for your failings. Spirit give you fruits of friendship. Sleep in peace tonight. Sleep soundly. Sleep in love. Weaver of dreams, weave well in you as you sleep. Amen. So thank you so much for being here today with me, and hope that you will come again and we will pray together. So happy to have Jean with us today. And all of you. And I hope someday that those who are not logged in will consider logging in so we may know you better. But at any rate, however it is, we just thank God for your presence and hope to see you again. So God bless you and namaste.